Today we'll be discussing a lab program 8, find minimum cost spanning tree of a given undirected graph using Kruskal's algorithm. Implement the program in Java language. So let us consider this undirected weighted graph and its corresponding cost matrix. Firstly, a spanning tree which consists of all the vertices and n minus 1 edges of the given original graph. For the given graph, there exists many spanning tree, so out of which we need to take up the graph, we need to take up the spanning tree which has a minimum cost. So the Kruskal algorithm finds the same. So let us solve this problem. In order to solve this problem, we need to go through a few steps. To solve this problem, I need to create the required variables, I need to create the required arrays to solve the problem. For me to solve this problem, so let me create one one-dimensional array. Let me call this array as parent array of size n. So we have 5 vertices in a given graph. Let us create an array of size 5. So let this index be 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So initially it consists of the same index value 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. And I need few variables like min. So min initially it will be 0. So I need one variable sum initially it will be 0, and I need one more variable count to count the number of edges. So initially its value will be 0. This is my first step. So let us proceed to a second step. Okay, we need to identify the minimum value in this matrix, so except 0. So we should not consider 0. So we need to identify the minimum value present in this matrix. So the minimum value present in this matrix is 2. So let me initialize this 2 in a variable min. So we need to check which edge is giving the 2. So edge from 1 to 3 is giving 2. So let me initialize this 1 to u. And the same value I will be initializing to variable I. So the heads from 1 to 3. So let me initialize this 3 inside V. The same value I will be initializing it inside variable J. So U, V, I, J. U and I consist of value 1. V and J consist of value 3. So now I need to check whether I should consider this edge from 1 to 3 or not. In order to check whether to consider this edge or not, I need to check two conditions. The first condition is that whether I should update the value of I or not. Whether I need to update the value of J or not. How to check? So in order to check whether the value of I to be updated or not, I need to check the parent of the previous step. So the parent of I, if it is same as the index value, so updation is not required. So let me check. What is parent of I? Parent of 1 is 1. Both are same, hence not required to update. Similarly, we need to check whether we want to update the value of J or not. So what is parent of J? What is parent of 3? Is parent of 3 is same as the index value? Yes, both are same. Hence updation is not required. So this is the first condition. And second thing we need to check. So if the value of I and J both are same, then we should not consider this edge. The value of I and J both are different, hence we need to consider an edge 1 2 3 1 2 3. The cost from 1 to 3 it is 2. So we have considered one edge, so the count value must be incremented by 1. Previously it was 0. 0 plus 1 it is equals to 1. So what is the cost of this edge? So I need to add to the variable sum. Previously it was 0. 0 plus minimum value 2. The sum is 2. So before proceeding to next step, I need to update the parent array. So let me write the previous value as it is. So whatever value we got in the last step. So we add the index value 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. And the values were like 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 and 5. So how to update the parent array? So in parent of j, I need to initialize I. I will repeat. In parent of 3, I need to initialize 1. So in parent of 3, I need to initialize 1. Okay, before proceeding to next step, check the count value. So if it is equals to 1 lesser than the number of vertices, then you need to stop performing the operation. So the count value is 1. 1 lesser than number of vertices must be equals to 4. So 1 is not equals to 4, hence we need to proceed. So before proceeding to next step, make that edge you consider as infinity. The edge from 1 to 3. 1 to 3 you make it as infinity. And 3 to 1 you make it as infinity. Okay, proceed to next step, step number 3. Okay, take the next minimum value, so except 0, check except 0. So the next minimum value is 3. So let me initialize that 3 inside variable min. So which edge is giving 3? So h from 2 to 3 we have 3. So initialize this 2 inside u, the same value will be initializing it inside I. So 2 to 3, let me initialize this 3 inside V. Let me initialize the same value inside J. Should we have to consider this edge or not? So in order to check whether to consider this edge or not, we need to check two conditions. One is whether to update I value and J value. So should I want to update I value? For that you need to check the previous step parent array. So what is parent of I? So means parent of 2. Is parent of 2 same as the index value? Yes. Hence we should not update this value. Similarly, you need to check j. Is parent of j, is parent of 3 equals to 3? No. Hence we need to update j value to its value 1. So it should not stop. Again, you need to check the parent of j. Until the parent of j is equals to its index value, you need to keep on updating. So what is parent of 1? So parent of 1 is same as index value, hence stop updating. So the second condition I need to check is I value and J value. If I value and J value both are same, you should not consider that H. So what is the value of I? 2. What is the value of J? Both are not same. Hence I need to consider a H. So what is the H? H from 2 to 3. So what is the cost of this H? Cost of this H is 3. So we have considered the second H. So count it was 1 plus I got one more edge, 1 plus 1 equals to 2. So what is a sum value? Sum previously it was 2. So we have considered one more edge and its cost is 3. So 2 plus 3 equals to 5. So before proceeding to next step, check whether to update parent array. So I need to update parent array. So this is my parent array. So of size 5. So index value 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So previously we had 1, 2, 1, 4 and 5. So in parent of j initialize 2 means j value is 1. In parent of 1 initialize 2. So in parent of 1 initialize 2. So before proceeding to next step, check the count value. If it is equals to 1 lesser than number of vertices, stop performing the operation. So is 2 is equals to 4? No. Hence I need to proceed. Before proceeding to next step, make this edge as infinity. 2 to 3 and 3 to 2 as infinity. So step number 4. Identify the next minimum value in this matrix except 0. So which is the minimum value? So 4. So let me initialize this 4 inside minimum variable. Which edge is giving 4? So edge from 3 to 4. So let me initialize this 3 inside u. Same value will be initializing inside I. So 4 I will be initializing it inside v. The same value will be initializing it inside j. Should I want to consider this edge? For that I need to check two conditions. The first condition is whether to update I value and j value. So what is parent of 3? Parent of 3. Is parent of 3 same as 3? No, it is 1. So hence I need to make I as 1. So you should not stop until the parent of I is same as its index value. So what is parent of 1? Parent of 1 is equals to 1? No. So it is 2. So let me update it to 2. What is parent of 2? 2 only. 2 and 2 same. Hence I need to stop updating. Okay, next coming to J. So parent of 4. Is parent of 4 equals to index value? Yes. Hence no need to update. Should I want to consider the set? Second condition, if I value and J value both are same, no need to consider that edge. I value is 2, J value is 4, hence don't consider, sorry, both are different, hence consider this edge. Edge from 3 to 4. The cost from 3 to 4 is 4. So the count, the number of edge count, previously it was 2 plus 1 is equals to 3. So the cost of this spanning tree, previously it was 5 plus 4, 9. So update parent array. So write down the previous value as it is. So we have 5 vertices, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So we have 2 here, 2, 1, 4, 5. So in parent of 4, in parent of J, place I. In parent of 4, place 1. Before proceeding to next step, so make this one means 3 to 4 as infinity and 4 to 3 as infinity. Okay, step number 5. So identify the next minimum value except 0. The minimum value is 5. So which edge is giving 5? So edge from 1 to 2 we have 5. So initialize this one inside U. Same value, I should initialize it inside I. Initialize 2 inside V. Let me initialize the same value inside J. So should I want to consider this edge? For that I need to check two conditions. The first condition is, should I want to update I value and J value? So parent of 1 is same as 1? No. Hence I value must be updated to 2. Parent of 2 same as 2? Yes. Stop updating. Similarly for J, is parent of 2 same as 2? Yes. Don't update. Second condition, if I value, J value both are same, don't consider the edge. I value 2, J value 2, both are same, hence should not consider this edge. Okay, if you do not consider the edge, don't increase the value of count, don't add the minimum value to sum. Okay, so not required to update the parent array as well. Okay, before proceeding to next step, check the count value. Is it equals to 1 lesser than number of vertices? No. Proceed. So before proceeding, make this one as infinity and this one as infinity. So step number 6. So next minimum value except 0. Again we have one more 5. So the edge 3 to 5 is giving 5. So let me initialize that minimum value inside min variable. The edge 3, let me initialize it inside u. Same value I will initialize it inside I. 3 to 5, I 5 I will be initializing it inside v. Same value I will initialize inside j. So should I want to consider that edge? So you need to check two conditions. The first condition is whether to update I value and J value. What is parent of I? Means parent of 3 is same as 3? No. Hence I need to update I to 1. What is parent of 1? Is same as 1? No. Hence I need to update to 2. What is parent of 2? Same as 2? Yes. Stop updating. What is parent of 5? Is same as 5? Hence stop updating. Second condition. If I value, J value same, don't consider this edge. I value is 2, J value is 5, both are different, hence I need to consider this edge from 3 to 5 with cost 5. So if you consider the edge, increase the value of count, previously it was 3 plus 1 equals to 4. Sum previously it was 9 plus the cost 5, 14. Before proceeding to next step, update parent array. So we have 5 vertices, so index value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let me write down the previous value as it is, 1, 1, 5. So in parent of J, place I. In parent of 5, place 2. Okay, before proceeding to next step, check the value of count. If it is equals to 1 lesser than number of vertices, totally we have 5 vertices. The number of edge count is equals to 4, 1 lesser than 5, hence we need to stop our operations. Hence we have identify the minimum cost spanning tree. The edges of minimum cost spanning tree is 1 to 3, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and 3 to 5. So the edges are like this: 1, 2, 3 with cost 2. Second edge 2 to 3 with cost 3. 3 to 4 with cost 4, and 3 to 5 with cost 5. I told you. So minimum cost spanning tree is a spanning tree where it should consist of all the vertices of the given graph, and the edge count must be 1 lesser than the number of vertices, where all the vertices must be connected with no cycle presets with the minimum cost. So this is the minimum cost spanning tree for the given graph. So the total cost of this graph is 14. Hope you have understood the logic of Kruskal's algorithm. Let us discuss the program. Okay, this is Kruskal's program, which is implemented using the Java language. So we have imported the packages required to our program. We have defined one class with a name Kruskal's algorithm. So we have declared variable n to read the number of vertices value, and we have declared one two-dimensional array, so which actually collects the cost of each edges, and we have defined one function read cost adjacency matrix. What actually this function does? This function reads the value of n and it reads the cost adjacency matrix value. So before reading a value, let me display a message saying that Kruskal's algorithm. So let me ask a user to enter number of nodes. So user will enter the integer value I should read from keyboard. To read values from a keyboard, I need to create object of inbuilt class scanner. With the help of scanner class, we need to read the values. Since the value of n is of type integer, I need to use this nextin function, collect that integer value inside n. Similarly, I need to read cost adjacency matrix. Before reading it, let me display a message saying that enter cost adjacency matrix. So you are not reading one value inside two-dimensional array. You are reading more than one value. You need to keep track of both row value as well as column value. So I create two for loop. The outer for loop will take care of your row value. The inner for loop will take care of your column value. So every time you read the integer value, let me collect inside the two-dimensional array A. By the time you come out of both the loops, so the entire cost matrix value would be collected. So we have a second function in the same class, find minimum spanning tree. What actually this function does? This function actually finds the minimum cost spanning tree with the Kruskal's algorithm logic. So as you know that I need one parent array, I need one minimum variable, I need one count variable, I need one sum variable, I need u, v, I, j, all these variables I need to declare. So I need one parent array, one dimensional array of type integer. So what must be initialized initially inside parent array? The same index value must be initialized inside parent array initially. So inside index 1, there must be value 1, index 2, 2, in index 5, 5. So in order to initialize this value, let me create one for loop. Since we are initializing more than one value, so this for loop must be executed for n time, starting from 1 up to n. So the parent of array, parent of I, must be the same I value. So 5 times it will be executed if the value of n is 5. So next, as I told you, I need to declare all required variables. I will declare count, sum, k, u, v. Initially all these variables will be 0. And notice here, so how long we have performed this operation? So till the count value is equals to n minus 1, we need to keep on performing these operations. And moreover, we are not performing it for one time, more than one time. Hence, we need to use loop. I am using while loop. Along we need to perform this operation till count not equals to n minus 1. Okay, I will initialize triple line inside minimum variable. Okay, next we need to find, the next step is we need to find the minimum value in the entire matrix. So I need to traverse the entire matrix to find the minimum value. So I need to use two for loop to traverse the entire matrix. So the first for loop will keep track of your row, and the inner for loop will keep track of your columns. Okay, so what I need to check, except zero value, I need to compare rest all value. Except zero, I need to compare all other values. Okay, and it must be lesser than min. So let me check a condition. If a of ij not equals to zero, and if it is lesser than min, so that value will be considered as min, and I need to note down the hedge giving the minimum value so that I will initialize this I value to u, j value to v. Okay, by the time you come out of this outer for loop, the actual minimum value in the array would be identified. Once the minimum value is identified, I need to check whether it is equals to 999. If at all, if it is equals to 999, it is understood that it is not a minimum value. I should come out of this loop. Let me create one break there. So if at all, if it is equals to 999, we'll come out of the loop. So what's the next step? So the next step is to check whether to update this u value and v value. So for that, I need to check this parent array. Okay, so what I do is I will initialize this u value to I, as we did the same in this. So u value was initialized inside I, so it was compared with parent array. So same thing I will be doing here. So u value is initialized inside I, so I need to check, so when to update this I value. If parent of u is same as the index value, don't update. If at all, if it is different, then update that variable I and j. Okay, let me check. If parent of I not equals to I, if at all, if it is not equals to I, initialize that value inside I. Okay, second time again, if parent of I not equals to I, so if at all, if it is not equals to I, initialize that value to I. If it becomes equals to I, stop updating the I value. So by the time you come out of this while loop, the updation would be done for I variable. Okay, similarly, I need to check whether to update j value or not. Before that, I need to initialize v value to j. Okay, let me initialize v to j. So I need to check parent of j not equals to j. If parent of j not equals to j, initialize parent of j to j. Again, if parent of j not equals to j, initialize that value to j. If parent of j becomes equals to j, then stop updating. By the time you come out of while loop, the j value would be updated. Okay, what's the next step? Next step is whether to consider the edge or not. So for that, we need to compare I value with J value. If both the values are same, don't consider that edge. Otherwise, consider that edge. So let me do the same thing. If I not equals to J, come inside, consider that edge. If I equals to J, I will not enter inside this if statement. If I do not enter inside this if statement, means that I will not consider that edge. Okay, assume the I value and J value are different. Hence, I need to consider that edge. So I need to note down the value of the edge. So for that, I have created one T array. So T is two dimensional array with column size 3 and row size n. Okay, assume the first edge is from 1 to 3 with cost 2. 1 to 3 with cost 2. So assume the index value 0, 1, 2, 3. The column value 0, 1, 2. Assume. Okay, I should note down this 1, 3 and 2. So the edge from 1 to 3 with cost 2. Let me initialize this 1 at t of 0, 0. Let me initialize this 3 at t of 0, 1. Let me initialize this minimum value at t of 0, 2. At last, I need to print this edges which makes the spanning tree. So I need to note down this value. Okay, so where I need to initialize one? In t of k 0. So initially k will be 0, so k will be pointing to the 0th row, and 0, so k 0 0, so u will be having this value and v will be having this value, and minimum variable will be having this value. So u value, I will be initializing it inside t k 0. V value must be initialized inside t k 1, and minimum value must be initialized inside t k 0. So before proceeding to next iteration, k value must be incremented. So I am doing the same, and I need to update this sum variable and count variable. So count must be incremented by 1 and sum must be updated with this minimum value. So minimum value must be added to this sum variable. Okay, I am doing the same. Sum equals to sum plus min. So count value is incremented. Before proceeding to next step, I need to update this parent array as well. So how to update parent array? In parent of j, I need to initialize I. I will repeat, in parent of j, I need to initialize I. I am doing the same here. In parent of j, I am initializing I. Before proceeding to next step, make this as infinity. So this 2, so 1, 3, I should make it as infinity, and 3, 1, I should make it as infinity, which means that a of uv and a of vu must be made infinity. Yes, we are doing the same. Okay, next iteration. Okay, next iteration. So again the count value is compared. If at all, if it is equals to n minus 1, so we'll come out of a while loop. Otherwise the operation will be repeated. Okay, by the time you come out of this loop, the spanning tree value, the spanning tree edges would be identified. So once I come out of this while loop, I will check the value of count. So if at all, if its value is equals to n minus 1, which means that we have identified the correct spanning tree. Otherwise, so the edges we have got does not make the correct spanning tree. So if it is equals to n minus 1, I will come inside. I will display one message saying that the minimum cost spanning tree with edges is. So let me display one message saying that edge and its corresponding weight. Okay, followed by, I need to traverse. Just now we have initialized all these edges and its minimum value in this two-dimensional array. I should traverse this two-dimensional array in order to display the edges and its cost. Okay, so to traverse that two-dimensional array, let me create one for loop. Okay, starting from 0 till n minus 1. While traversing, I need to display the first row value, second row value, till the last row value. So I will be pointing to row, and the column value, 0th column value I should display, followed by one arrow mark, followed by I and column 1 value, followed by T of I and column 2 value. Okay, this would be executed for n time. By the time you come out of this for loop, so all the edges with its corresponding value would be displayed, and the total cost which make the spanning tree must be displayed, and it is initialized in, it is stored in the sum variable. So I will display that value as well. So otherwise, if count value is not equals to n minus 1, I should display one message saying that spanning tree does not exist. So this is the closure of the function and the closure of class. So we have defined our main function inside another class. There is a call to this first class to invoke the two functions, read cost adjacency matrix, and the second function, find minimum spanning function. Okay, this is your lab program H. Thank you.